John 7:38.
Because this is the whole point, big bro. Again, like my brother was just showing you, if you don't seek the Most High God, where would you seek him? In the Bible. If you're not doing that, John 7:38. And listen to this. Read.
John 7:38. He that believeth on me.
Right. This is Christ speaking. He said, he that believeth on me. The brother was just explaining what Christ looked like out of the Bible, right? Not what society in the world puts in front of our face every day. Catholicism, right? And it gives you that white Jesus, blonde hair, and blue eyes, right? Read.
He that believeth on me, as the scriptures have said.
As the scriptures had said. You understand where I'm coming from, big bro? Read.
Out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
He says, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. Basically, you're going to be able to gain the kingdom because you're believing on these scriptures as it is said. You're not going to be fooled with wise words. Wisdom, what do you call that today? Motivational speakers. T.D. Jakes, Creflo Dollar, Juanita Bynum. All of that, those words of wisdom, all they do is make you feel good. Once you leave out of there, all of your afflictions that the brother was bringing out back in Deuteronomy, all those curses, they still waiting on you as soon as you come out of that feeling of that church. You get where I'm coming from? So at the end of the day, big bro, you got to seek God out of this Bible.
Right.
That's what we trying to push, is so that you'll understand. Only way you're going to get the kingdom of heaven is if you go through this Bible. Did you read that? Give me that. Give me that. Get that kingdom of heaven. Watch this. We're dealing with what Christ said. We ain't dealing with what these churches going to teach us. We're going to follow with the example that Christ gave us on how we're supposed to reach our brothers and sisters. When he sent us out, when he sent the disciples out, he sent the 70 elders out across the whole entire earth. The dispersion of the diaspora of us. Matthew's 19 and verse 16. So this is what you're going to find out when you're seeking in this Bible. This is the whole conclusion of it. And we'll get that next. Read.
Matthew 19:16. And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?
A man came to Jesus and said, what can I do so that I can gain the kingdom of heaven? Right? This is what he's asking Christ. Listen to what Christ said.
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good?
Christ said, why call me good? We walk around talking about, bro, are you good? Yeah, I'm good. Christ said, why callest me good? Two different understandings, right? Read.
There is none good but one, that is God.
God. That's the only person on this earth that ever walked was good. Christ told us he wasn't even good. But the Christian church will tell you, you can't be like Christ. Christ was perfect. But Christ will tell you, be like your father. Christ wasn't good. He told us that he wasn't good. But listen up, because the point that we're getting to is this. Read.
But if thou wilt enter into life.
If you want to get the kingdom of heaven, read.
Keep the commandment.
Do what?
Keep the commandment.
No, believe that they're just spiritual, and I'm a spiritual Israelite.
Keep the commandments.
The laws are done away with.
Keep the commandments.
That is a very repetitive theme from the book of Genesis all the way to Revelation, big bro. It does not change. The laws have not been done away with.
Right.
You see what the brother was going into? All of those laws Christ came to fulfill was his sacrifice. That was it. So all of the moral, the dietary, that's why we go into, we shouldn't eat pork. The Muslims, they got that from us. Every nation on this planet, they saw what God gave us and they patterned some laws for themselves, just what we're supposed to be doing. That's why we the greatest people on this earth. The brother was just reading that to you. That's why they all want to be like us. What are they doing? They wearing their hair. They trying to get woolly hair. They try to steal our culture as far as music, dance, you name it. Cook it. Whatever we do good and we excel in it, because we'll create it, but they'll take it. But you'll see that we go far past than what they could ever do. You see what I'm saying? These are some of the things that plague our people. One of them right now, I'm gonna show you an example right now. So like the brother was saying, I'm from this part of town too. All of these houses that's missing right now, the curses came, the drug came, right? Now what are they doing? They created something what they call your local neighborhood white man. They created something called the gentrification. You know what that is, right? Two blocks down, you can see the houses that they're building right there. Why are they doing that? Because you see this store right here? It won't be too long before they're gonna push him out, ask him, give him some money, and he's gonna be gone. At the end of all of that, where are we gonna be then? Where's Big Mama and Big Daddy and them gonna stay? Because they coming in, they building all these high rises, these new luxury apartments and everything. We can't afford all that. Well, you know, we the last hired, first fired. We don't make the top money at the job, but we getting somewhere around minimum wage. We can't afford that. You see what I'm saying? I promise you, ain't nobody paying $1,500, $1,600, $1,700 a month for the housing around here. If they are, how much longer? Because when they start building around you, it's gonna increase. You see what's going on? And then we start going out the door. Oh, well, let's go over here. We can afford this and do that. So this is what we're showing you, big bro. These are all of the curses that have come upon us as a people, and we have not learned yet, because all praises to the brother. Brother gave us 2 minutes of his ear, and you still sitting here, big bro. That's a humbling spirit right there. You taking a moment just to hear what the word of God says. And so with that, give me Revelation 1. And this is how you being blessed, bro. This is how you being blessed. We hear that in the Christian church all day long. Oh, I'm blessed and highly favored. What is being blessed and highly favored? Revelation 1, read that. Read on, start verse 3. Watch this. This is, again, this is out of the Bible. Have a Christian explain to you, why am I blessed? And when they start to explain to you, see if they're going to grab a Bible and show you in the Bible what it says. But if you believe in the Most High God, as Christ said, if you believe on me, as the scripture said, you're going to go to the Bible and get that information. But listen to this. Read.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 3. Blessed is he that readeth.
Hold on. What's that first, that second word?
Blessed is he that readeth.
Blessed is he that readeth. Read.
And they that hear the words of this prophecy.
It says, and they that hear the words of this prophecy. Right now, y'all listening, brother. Y'all been patient. Y'all humbling yourselves. Not to throw doctrines out there, but that's one thing. You can, if you have some other belief in your mind and you want to throw it out there, what we're going to do, we're here to take those doctrines and show you what the Bible truly says about those doctrines, and not to do those things, because they're not pleasing to the Most High God. And that's what we're out here doing. So listen to this again from the beginning. Read that again from the top.
Verse 3.
Read it so he can understand it. Read.
Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein.
You hear that, bro? He said, and those that keep the things that are written therein. So what are we doing right now? You see the brothers right here in purple and gold? We're keeping the things that are written herein. Exodus 20 and verse 8. Showing you that we're keeping. Read that, Exodus 20 and 8, because this is what's written in the Bible. Right now, you're a living example showing that when you see these brothers in purple and gold, they ain't told me nothing that wasn't written in the Bible. But here's one right now. Read.
Exodus chapter 20, verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day.
This is one of the Ten Commandments. Exodus 20 and verse 8. The fourth commandment of the ten. It says what?
Remember the Sabbath day.
Today is the Sabbath day. The brother touched that already. Read.
To keep it holy.
To keep it holy. I heard him talking about what's holy. Keep it separate. Because 6 days of the week, from Sunday to Friday, you're keeping the world's customs and traditions. God knew we were going to be in the time, so he left us this as our comforter, to follow the instructions and guidelines, which are the principles that Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and all of his descendants followed. They followed the words that are in this book. They wasn't swayed to the left with wisdom of words, being creative. Ha! Can I get a witness now? What is all that profitable for? You see what I'm saying? All that is just noise, bro. All of that is just noise. Wise words, wisdom from the Greek philosophy. It's just philosophy. Now that I can sway you, oh, you like that, you won't come back. What did the pastor or preacher talk about? He talked about this one scripture, but for an hour and a half, he just went on and on. And went, now the band cranked up. Am I lying? That's exactly what he's doing. And at the end of all that foolery, let me give you $10 for your time, or can you pay a tithe or offering? You see what I'm saying? Listen to this. Listen, let him finish this up, and then you good, big bro. All right?
6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy works. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou nor thy sons, nor thy daughters, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant.
So what you just heard before you go, big bro, God, you're seeing the brothers out here, like I was saying, keeping this commandment. And it's not just one, because God said if you break one, you've broken them all. So with all due repentance, because like the brother said, all of us was on that side, right? All we did was, wait a minute, I've been taught this, let me put that up against what the Bible says. And then I start examining myself. That's what all Paul taught. Examine yourself. 1 Corinthians 13:5. Examine yourself whether you be in the truth of Christ, keeping the commandments, or you're going to be in truth of the world. Friday night, I'm going to go out, kick it, get drunk, lay down with somebody, do something bad to somebody's daughter. Then I wake up in the morning, I'm in church. Hallelujah, song, dancing, feeling good, pastor sound good once again. Now you're going to repeat that whole cycle of keeping the world's customs. So that's what we're trying to show you, big bro.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.